This
I'm
conference
gonna
will
get out
now
of
be
my
recorded.
okay. Heroes, as I already told you, we'll take the liver. So let us start with the anatomy of the liver. So this is the diagram of the liver. Any of you know the lobes of the liver? Apart from right and left. What are the very small lobes of the liver? Okay.
Parotid and
parotid
lobe.
Very good. Very good. Okay, let us briefly go to the embryology. The liver primordium begins to form in the third week of the development as an outgrowth of endodermal epithelium, known as the hepatic diverticulum or hepatic part. The cell population is bipotential and cells may develop into hepatocytes or intrahepatic duct cells. So it is arising from the junction of the foregut and midgut, grow into ventral mesogastrium and into septum transversum. You hear, Linara? The liver endothelium is derived from the vitelline and umbilical veins. Both merge to form the liver sinusoids and liver connective tissue. The hemopoietic cells and Kupffer cells are derived from the mesoderma of the septum transversum. You hear, Gutunayama? Septum transversum. So all of you know this is the largest organ, measuring about 1.2 to 1.7 kg depending on the weight of the candidate, covered by capsule on all aspects except the bare area, divided into large 3/4 right lobe and small left lobe. This is the anatomical lobes. These are the anatomical lobes. You know the location, right upper abdomen, because I will go through, because there are so many slides. And I will forward this PPT to you, okay? Beneath the right diaphragm, beneath the diaphragm, under cover of right costal margin, under cover of right hemidiaphragm, it separates it from pleural, lungs, pericardium, heart. So these are the lobes of the liver, right and left, and cardiac and foregut lobes. So these are the anatomical names. So the right and left lobes are divided by, how do you divide? What is the ligament which divides? What is this ligament?
Falciform ligament.
Arangala Satan Chapali. The falciform ligament divides the right lobe into right and left lobes. This is the anatomical description. And in the under surface and on the posterior surface, there will be this the cardiac lobe and this is the quadrant lobe. So this is the, but surgically it is not divided. Falciform ligament is not the dividing point between the, this is all the left lobe, surgical left lobe, and this is all the surgical right lobe. So actually this is the anatomical left lobe, but this is all the surgical left lobe. So this line is called Cantil's line. This will come across in the due course. Okay. So the falciform ligament separates the anatomically into left and right. But surgically it is divided by the Cantil's line. That will come across in due course. Okay. So relations anteriorly, we go through all these things. I will send the PPT. Just to keep the anatomy book and go through, because some of the people may like to ask. Posteriorly, these are the relations. What is porta hepatis? This is the porta hepatis. And you know what is this surface? Which surface of the liver this is? surface. See, you are not able to see the false wall ligament. False wall ligament is seen in the anterior aspect. So this is the posterior aspect and posterior inferior aspect, because you are seeing the gallbladder and the portal thread also. This is the portal thread. To the portal thread and gallbladder. That means this is the inferior surface. This is all the posterior surface where you are able to see the caudate lobe. Caudate lobe lies in the posterior aspect of the liver, remember. And what is this? What is this? Inferior vena cava. So, Cantil's line somewhere goes like this. The Cantil's line somewhere goes like this. Okay, so this is all left lobe. This is from here, it is the right lobe. Okay, and this porta hepatis contains right and left hepatic ducts, right and left branch of the hepatic artery, right and left branch of the portal vein, and the sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves and the lymphatics. And at the hilum, that is somewhere here. It will be there will be portal hepatic lymph nodes also will be present, and the peritoneal ligaments. How many? This is the so this is which surface? When you are seeing the ligament like this, anterior surface. Very good. This is anterior surface. So this is the falciform form ligament, and there will be other ligaments 2 and 3. They are the coronary ligaments. They are called the coronary ligaments. Okay, and the 2 and 3 are the coronary ligaments. They are the peritoneal reflections. And at the end of the coronary ligaments, there will be, see the end of the coronary ligament, this is the triangular ligament. Right triangular ligament, right triangular ligament, and left triangular ligament. And this is the lesser omentum. Lesser omentum, otherwise known as gastrohepatic ligament. Not lesser omentum. What is the importance of the lesser omentum? The free edge of the lesser omentum, all these portal threads will be going. This bile duct, portal, hepatic artery, and portal. And what is this foramen?
Foramen of Winslow.
Foramen of Winslow. So this is the posterior, under surface, posterior under surface. So falciform ligament will be anterior. So this is the left triangular ligament, right triangular ligament, this is the right triangular ligament. Okay, coronary ligament, upper coronary, lower coronary ligament. So these are the, so in between is the, this is all the bare area of the liver. So bare area means the liver which has got no peritoneal covering. You remember this point, peritoneal covering. So this is the ligamentum teres, this is the obliterated paraumbilical vein. This is the ligamentum teres. And sixth one is the ligamentum venosum, which is the obliterated ductus venosus, which is present in the fetal line. So by the adult side, it will be obliterated. So this is the ligamentum venosum. This is the ligamentum teres. Ligamentum teres. So anteriorly in this line, there will be anteriorly in this line, there will be falciform ligament. Whereas the surgical lobes, this is the Cantil's line. So I told you Cantil's line will be passing from the gallbladder bed to the inferior vena. So somewhere here. Somewhere here. It will be Cantil's line, which originally separates the right lobe into left lobe. So bare area of the liver is the area where there is no peritoneal covering. You remember this part. So these are the coronary ligaments, this is the upper coronary, lower coronary, this is the right triangular ligament, this is the left triangular ligament. So this is another description, same ligamentum, lesser omentum attachment is the bare area. So from here, the lesser omentum will be attached. So that is gastrohepatic ligament. So liver blood supply, all of you know what is the blood supply of the liver? Arterial supply, both are there. It has got dual blood supply. 80%, 75 to 80% are from the portal vein, and 20 to 25% is from the hepatic artery. So the hepatic artery arises from the celiac trunk. So hepatic artery is fully oxygenated blood. So this is from the systemic circulation, whereas this from portal vein, that is from the other parts of the gastrointestinal tract, the portal vein also goes through the supplies the liver. It goes through the liver for detoxification and other actions of the liver. So the hepatic artery is major and supplies larger portion of the right side of the liver, right hepatic artery. So hepatic artery is a branch of celiac artery. It divides into right and left branches. They supply the right lobe and left. Venous is from the portal vein. So though portal vein is a venous blood, but it mainly passes through the, see, this is the portal vein, mainly passes through the liver. This is also, so that means the liver is having dual blood supply, both from the portal vein and from the hepatic artery. And venous drainage is through the hepatic veins. Venous drainage is mainly through hepatic veins. There will be three hepatic veins, left, middle, and right hepatic veins. So lymphatics, half of the lymph is formed by the liver and it goes to the lymph nodes in the, so we can see the lymph nodes will go to the lymph nodes in the porta hepatis, and from here they go to the celiac group of lymph nodes, and from the bare area of the liver to the diaphragm they will go to the posterior mediastinal lymph nodes also. So this also you have to keep in your mind, not only to the porta hepatis, they will go to the mediastinal lymph nodes also. So this is the superficial and deep lymphatics. This you can read the anatomy textbooks by keeping this slide with you. So nerve supply, sympathetic nerve supply from celiac ganglion, parasympathetic is from, anybody can tell? Meer stomach cheppara, vagus nerve stomach ko cheppara?
Yes, sir.
So it is from the hepatic division of the anterior vagal front. Anterior vagal front. Okay, how many vagal trunks are there? When I say anterior, there will be
posterior.
Posterior also. Our rental ni cut chese operation ni vagotomy antaru. ట్రిప్టి కల్చర్ మేనేజ్మెంట్లో చెప్పుంటారు మళ్ళీ యూ రికలెక్ట్. సో ఫ్రమ్ ది యాంటీరియర్ వేగస్ నర్వ్ దెర్ విల్ బి అ డివిజన్ కాల్డ్ హెపాటిక్ డివిజన్ విచ్ సప్లైస్ ది లివర్. యూ రిమెంబర్ దిస్ పాయింట్, లివర్ అండ్ గాల్ బ్లాడర్కి ఆ హెపాటిక్ డివిజన్ ఫ్రమ్ ది యాంటీరియర్ వేగస్ నర్వ్ సప్లై చేస్తుంది, దట్ ఈస్ పారాసింపథటిక్ సప్లై. సింపథెటిక్ ఈస్ ఫ్రమ్ ది సీరియస్ గ్యాంగ్లియా నుంచి ఆ సింపథెటిక్ నర్వ్ ఫైబర్స్ వై ఆర్ దీస్ ఆర్టరీస్ అండ్ veins welter. And the IVC is very important in the anatomy of the liver because it is embedded almost, the inferior vena cava is embedded in the posterior surface of the liver, very closely adherent, very closely attached, and sometimes it forms a tunnel in the posterior aspect of the liver. So the inferior vena cava attachment is also very important. And this anatomy is also very important because the hepatic veins, see the left hepatic vein, middle hepatic vein, and the right hepatic veins, they join the inferior vena. So originally these are the venous drainages, the venous hepatic veins which drain into the inferior vena cava, right, middle, and left. So this is the, you see, this is the vena cava, right vena cava. Vena cava, and this is the caudate lobe. See, you can see the caudate lobe is almost is in the posterior aspect of the liver. Caudate lobe, whereas quadrate lobe is in the inferior aspect of the liver. And the right just to the left of the gallbladder, caudate lobe. Whereas caudate lobe is inferior and the posterior surface. You see, to the left of the inferior vena cava. This is the caudate lobe. These fine anatomical relationships are very important because of the hepatic resections and hepatectomy operations. You please go through all these things. Of course, these are the same. So the hepatic veins, I already told you, three hepatic veins is the left, middle, and right hepatic veins. Lie in the, they are called scissurae. Scissurae is the plural. So they lie in the portal scissurae enter. So the left hepatic, so this is the portal scissura, left portal scissura, in which there will be left hepatic vein. This is the main portal scissura in which the middle hepatic vein lies. And this is the right portal scissura where the right hepatic vein will be present. So this is the anatomical division. So this is the Cantil's line. So Cantil's line will be going somewhere like this. Okay. So that means to the left of the middle hepatic vein, this is all the left lobe. This is all the left lobe. Surgical left lobe. This is all the surgical left lobe. This is the right lobe. To the right of the middle hepatic vein, this is all the right lobe. So this is the portal vein. You know how it is formed. So this is the complete portal venous drainage diagram. You just tell me the point how it is formed. Portal vein. Meeku medicine lo kuda cheppuntaru. This is what is this vein. The portal vein is formed by joining.
Venous vein and central vein.
This is superior. Superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein. Superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein. Both join forming the main hepatic, I mean portal vein. So the portal vein at the portal hepatis, it divides into left branch and the right branch. You see, the left branch is always bigger. Left branch is always bigger. Likewise, left hepatic artery also very big. Left hepatic duct also very big because this is the almost this is the place of the hide. So the what is portal triad? So portal triad contains three hepatic artery, hepatic vein, portal vein, and
common bile ducts.
Common bile. అక్కడ కామన్ బైల్ డక్ట్ కాదు, అక్కడ కామన్ హెపాటిక్ డక్ట్. ఫోర్త్ హెపాటిస్ కామన్ హెపాటిక్ డక్ట్. అది ఆఫ్టర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కమింగ్ డౌన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ జాయిన్డ్ బై సిస్టిక్ డక్ట్ గివింగ్ రైజ్ టు కామన్ డక్ట్. ఓకే, సో దట్ ఈస్ ది ఇంట్రా హెపాటిక్ పోర్షన్ ఆఫ్ ది పోర్టల్ వెయిన్. సి ది పోర్టల్ వెయిన్ అగైన్ ఆల్సో విల్ బి what is this cleavages, what do you call this cleavages? I told you scissura. So in the scissura is the left portal, left hepatic vein, middle hepatic vein, and right hepatic vein. Likewise, the left portal vein, right portal vein. And it also gives a middle portal vein, but mainly it is having two branches, left and right. And these are the anatomical locations, I mean surgical lobes of the liver. 1, 2, 3, 4. You see, this is all the left lobe. And this is all the 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the right lobe. So that means the right lobe is between the right lobe and left lobe, entire left lobe. This is the, what is this vein? here? Not this. What is this vein? Middle hepatic vein is the vein in the middle of the middle between the left and right hepatic veins, which separates the surgical lobes of the liver. So it will be like this, the extra hepatic gland. So this is the just like in the finger, you see. So this is the left branch. So the left, either left hepatic artery or left portal vein or left common hepatocyte will be like this. Will be left will be always bigger than the right. This is the direction of the fingers. This is the direction of the ducts. So after entering into the liver, it forms a biliary system. It forms into, this is the portal vein. Portal vein having three, this is the portal vein. This is the bile duct, portal bile duct radical, and of course hepatic artery branch is not shown here, and it is having sinusoids. So this is the original picture. This is called the liver lobule. So the liver lobule is hexagonal. So each lobule will be having six portal tracts. Six portal tracts. They are hexagonal shape and they are connected in the center by the at the central vein. At the central vein. See, this is the portal vein which is going through these are the hepatocytes. They are the hepatocytes. In between the hepatocytes, there will be sinusoids which are finally going to the central vein. So likewise, there will be five like this. Five portal valves will be entering into the, I mean portal vein radicals will be finally draining into the central vein, which finally forms the hepatic veins. So this is from where in between the hepatocytes, you can see the greenish lines. This is the bile ductules, where bile formation will be there. And finally, they will go to the bile ductules and finally common hepatic. Finally, common hepatic duct. See, all the ductules will form the common. See, left common left branch of the common hepatic duct, right branch of the common hepatic duct, and this is the common hepatic duct. See, the common hepatic duct is joined by the cystic duct, giving rise to common bile duct. It joins along with the pancreatic duct in the duodenal papilla. So, this is the sphincter of Bowden. So all this anatomy is very important in understanding the various diseases. So I will send this PPT. You please go through this. Okay. So each hepatic lobule, so having it comprises of plates of liver cells or hepatocytes separated by venous channels or hepatic sinusoids. Inside the sinusoids, many functions of the liver take place, including bile formation. Bile flows in the opposite direction to finally reach the hepatic duct. So the portal blood and hepatic artery, they enter the liver. Whereas from liver, the bile will be in the opposite direction. They will come in through the common bile duct, common hepatic duct, and the common bile duct into the liver. So in the opposite direction. So this is the extrahepatic biliary system. So this bigger one. What is this? Number two. When it is big, like finger. Yes. Which one this is? Left or right arm?
Left.
Left. Always remember, left branches will be lengthier. Left common hepatic duct. Left branch of the portal vein. Left hepatic artery. They will be bigger. And the right will be directly going like this. So when you place like this, the left is index finger and the right is thumb. Directly thumb directly going into the right. Okay, you know this again. We will repeat in gallbladder also. and it will be this point will be coming again and again. Common hepatic duct, left hepatic duct, left and right hepatic ducts, common hepatic duct, joined by the cystic duct, forming the common bile duct, which joins with the, along with the pancreatic duct. What is the name of the pancreatic duct? Duct of Virchow. So both these join and form in the second part of the duodenum. Open into the second part of the duodenum and the ampulla of the pater duodenal papilla. So this is the duodenal papilla. You see, this is the common bile duct. This is the pancreatic duct. Both put together, they are opening into the, this is the second part of the duodenum. This is the open. And so this area is called the duodenal papilla. You see, this is at the second part of the duodenum. You can see it as a opening. This is called the duodenal papilla. Okay. All these things are very important because periampullary carcinoma will be occurring here. Periampullary carcinoma, the gallbladder will be occurring in this area. Periampullary carcinoma of the pancreas or common bile duct, all these occurring in the very important. So all these things we'll discuss in the continuation. So both the common bile duct and pancreatic duct, they are covered by the sphincter of Horay. It is having so many portions. The sphincter, the muscular layer which is connecting the common bile duct, the muscular layer which is connecting the pancreatic duct, and the muscular layer which is connecting both, and the muscular layer at the near the papilla. So these are the parts of the sphincter of Horay. This is also very important because this is at the time of ERCP and all those things, this sphincterotomy operations, this sphincter anatomy is very important. This we will come across in due course. So the bile duct blood supply, you always remember, the bile duct blood supply, they will be coming from the, this, what it is? Right hepatic artery. So they will be coming from the right hepatic artery and cystic artery in a longitudinal manner. So parallel, they are just parallel to the common bile. This is also very important. Because in the operations of the common bile duct, you should not cut like this. If you cut, the blood supply will be lost. So this is also very important. They are in the axial arrangement. So they are in parallel to the common bile duct. All these things, why I am telling is, you have to read and you have to remember, because at the time of operations, all the anatomy is very important in the case of gallbladder and liver resections. So the Kallert's triangle, hepatocystic triangle, Kallert's triangle, pair in Nara. So Kallert's triangle, yes, is bounded by Vinarama, cystic duct, common hepatic duct, and cystic artery. So this is the small triangle in the Kallert's triangle. Whereas in so many books, the other triangle is also described with the hepatocystic triangle. So that means common bile duct, cystic duct, and the under surface of the liver. So hepatocystic triangle. So some people may ask these questions. So cystic, the Kallert's triangle is a part of hepatocystic triangle. You remember, of course, this is mainly for the specialists. The hepatocystic triangle is bounded by gallbladder wall and cystic duct. See, cystic duct and gallbladder wall, and under surface of the liver, common hepatic duct and cystic artery. Okay. So the Kallert's triangle is within the hepatocystic triangle. You just remember this name, and you recollect the boundaries of this, because invariably it will be asked in the exam, what is Kallert's triangle, what is hepatocystic triangle. Of course, common hepatic duct, cystic artery, and this is the very important functional anatomy. I already told you, this is called the Punnett's. Punnett, you remember this name, Punnett's functional anatomy. Puniyat and Bhishma. Mainly Puniyat has divided the liver into 8 lobes. 8 segments, not lobes, 8 segments. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is A and B. 5, 6, 7, 8. So, you see, this is the middle hepatic vein. This is the left hepatic vein. And this is the right hepatic vein. So, this part of the liver is called right caesura. You see, right caesura. This is the main caesura, arterial caesura, as the left caesura. So, in left caesura, there will be left hepatic vein. In main caesura or median caesura, there will be middle hepatic vein. And in right caesura, there will be right hepatic. Likewise, right branch of the right branches of the right portal vein. Likewise, bile ducts also will be like this. So they will be having this segmental arrangement by this fissure and all those things. And this is described by the Conneaut in 1957. So this is called segments of the Conneaut. So in this, you can see this is all the left lobe. Actually, falciform ligament will be somewhere here. See, umbilical fissure or falciform ligament will be somewhere here. That means this is the left lobe and this is all the right lobe, anatomically. Whereas this segmentally, the left lobe will be somewhere up to here. Okay, so the left lobe, the surgical division of the left lobe is from the inferior vena cava, middle hepatic vein, and the portal vein, or portal hepatic, somewhere. It will be going like this. This line is called Cantil's line. So you have to remember these names, Conneaut segments and the Cantil's line. Conneaut divides the liver into 8 segments, that is the functional unit. Each segment is having separate branches of hepatic artery, portal vein, and hepatic artery. So the left and right, functional right and left unit along the line between the gallbladder fossa and the middle hepatic vein. That is called Cantil's line. You also remember this point. See, gallbladder fossa. So the Cantil's line will be going from the gallbladder fossa to the middle hepatic vein. That means in middle caesura of the liver. So that is the functional unit which divides actually the right and left. They are called the surgical lobes or functional lobes of the liver. So liver segments 5 to 8 to the right of this line are supplied by the right hepatic artery, right branch of the portal vein, and drained bile via the right hepatic. So you remember 1 to 4 is left liver, left 1 to 4 functional units belong to left functional liver, left lobe of the liver, surgical lobe of the liver, and 5 to 8 are called 5 to 8 are right lobe of the right surgical lobe of the liver. 5 to 8 are the segments. See, this is the falciform. If you see anteriorly, it will be falciform ligament will be like this. So you call it as the left lobe, and this is the right lobe. These are the anatomical division. Whereas surgically, this is the Cantil's line. So the Cantil's line will be passing somewhere in the gallbladder fossa to the middle hepatic vein. So this is the inferior vena cava. Middle hepatic vein will be some middle. Left hepatic vein will be like this. Right hepatic vein will be like this. So middle hepatic vein, it will be passing like this, and this is the gallbladder fossa. So this is called the Cantil's line. Which way? So this is all the left lobe. To the left of the Cantil's line is the left lobe. To the right of the Cantil's line is the right lobe. This is called the surgical lobes or functional units of the liver. And the left lobe is having 4 segments. The left lobe will be having 4 segments. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And right lobe will be having 4 segments. 5, 6, 7, 8. Like this. Of course, they are separated by these fissure and branches of the hepatic veins and hepatic arteries and the bile ducts. You see how the hepatic vein, this is the intervena cava. See, this is the left hepatic vein, this is the middle hepatic vein, and this is the right hepatic vein. And the branches are so that, like that, so it will be first, second, third, and fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth. So the main line is, what is this portal vein? That means somewhere this is the portal hepatic. So this is the porta hepatis, and gallbladder will be somewhere here. Gallbladder will be somewhere here. So the porta hepatis, the middle hepatic vein. This is the line which divides the functional or surgical lobes of the liver. So the left of this is the left lobe. To the right of this is the left lobe, right lobe. So this line is the Cantil's line. This is the Cantil's line. So this is the Cantil's line. Okay. So when you see from behind, so this is the Cantil's line. Cantil's line will be passing from the gallbladder fossa to the inferior vena. Inferior vena cava means here, somewhere in the, somewhere here it will be median, middle hepatic. So this is the Cantil's line. To the left, it is all the left lobe. So by looking at this, the left lobe looks very big there. In width it is very bigger than the right lobe. So the bulk will be in the right. So this is the line of passing the Cantil's line, and this is the left lobe. So left lobe is having 1, 2, 3, 4, and right lobe is having 5, 6, 7, 8 will be anterior. So in each surface you cannot see these 8 segments in any one surface. You remember, for example, this is the posterior. When you are seeing the IVC and this gallbladder, this is the posterior inferior surface. So posterior inferior surface, you are not able to see the eighth segment here. Okay, eighth segment here and 4A segment also. So likewise, of course, fourth segment on the of the left lobe is having two portions, 4A and 4B, and you are not able to see the 4A, which will be anterior. So this is the posterior inferior surface of the liver. See, the liver is roots from its inferior aspect. Inferior aspect. So when you lift the liver from the inferior aspect up to the very full dragging, you can see the IVC also. Of course, this ligamenta venosum, portal fissure, all these things, please read. So these are the finally they are the divisions. The left lobe. This is the anatomical left lobe, and this is the main surgical left lobe. So this is the, what is this line? This is the Cantil's line. Cantil's line. This is the false lobe. So anteriorly, when you see, the false vein ligament divides the left and right. These are the anatomical lobes. Whereas functionally, the Cantil's line divides, which is passing through the gallbladder fossa to the middle hepatic vein. So somewhere here will be the inferior vena cava. So this is all the left lobe, and this is the right lobe, and the arterial and ducts and portal vein branches will be like that, and again they will be again divided into medial and see lateral segment, anterior lateral, medial superior, medial inferior, like this. So just you keep chaurasia or Gray's anatomy along with you, and again you recollect. Okay, these are the functional lobes of the liver. So when you see from the inferior surface, can anybody tell what is this? What is this line? This is the line of the anteriorly. This is the line of the false vein ligament. Here it is. Ligamentum teres and ligamentum venosum. Okay. is the left caesura, left caesura. This is the Cantor's leg. This is the Cantor's leg passing through the gallbladder to the left of the inferior vena. And this is all the right leg. Again, right also will be divided into anterior inferior and anterior posterior inferior. Right anterior and right posterior. So these, why, how they are divided? Because of the branching of the hepatic veins and hepatic arteries, and bile ducts will be like this in the interior of the liver, which give the segmental or lobules of the liver, surgical segments of the liver. So like this. So if you see on the anterior aspect, see, this is the anterior aspect. This is the falciform ligament, where you are not able to see the first one. What is that first one? Caudate lobe. Caudate lobe will be in the posterior surface, close to the inferior vena cava. It comes to the caudate lobe, posterior. See, zero. You see caudate lobe. First one is the caudate lobe, which is on the left of the to the inferior vena cava, to the left of the inferior vena cava, and passing a caudate process out. So all these things you define, because it will be asked, discuss the surgical anatomy of the liver, and then they will ask obstructive jaundice or liver abscess or portal hepatitis, something like that. So surgical anatomy is also very important. So this is a bismuth functional segment, same. So Coniates, and later he bismuth has divided the same, depending on, because he identified the fissures, caesura. I told you caesura. Caesura is just a depression. If you take the liver into consideration, it will be having three depressions. Left caesura, in which there will be left hepatic vein, middle or median caesura, main caesura, in which the middle hepatic vein, and right caesura, in which the right hepatic vein. Same. So Bismuth also has fortified the knowledge of this Coniates segmental anatomy in the liver. See, this is the anatomical lobe, falciform ligament, where the surgical lobes is, what is this line? Repeatedly I am telling, Cantor's line. Cantor's line, C-A-N-T-L-I-E, Cantor's line. This is very important in the examination, it will be asked. So how they are divided? This is the caesura. Bismuth has named these things as caesura. So the depressions in the liver. Caesura. This is the left caesura, main caesura, and right caesura. So nothing but the left caesura, left hepatic vein, main caesura, middle hepatic vein, right caesura, right hepatic vein. So likewise, from down, this is the right portal vein. You see, right hepatic vein, right portal. Middle hepatic vein and middle portal. And there is no middle portal vein. It middle portal vein comes from the right portal. And you see the big one, the left portal vein. So it is having in communication with the hepatic vein. So all of these hepatic venules and portal venules, they will be forming the sinusoids or the metabolic activity of the liver. So, but anyway, that is the physiology. This is the anatomy. The surgical lobes are divided by Cantor's line into 8 segments. 1 to 4 are from to the left, and 5 to 8 are to the right. See, here are the caesuras. So, in the caesura, there will be from above you can see the hepatic veins, and from below you can see the hepatic arteries and the biliary ducts and portal. Right. So this is the portal, right? So here, where is the Cantor's line? So always remember Cantor's line to the left of the, to the right of the inferior vena cava, slightly right. So this is the Cantor's line to the gallbladder portion. So to the gallbladder, this is the, somewhere here it will be the Cantor's line, which divides the right hepatic लेफ्ट है पैकेज, सर्जिकल ग्लोव्स आर सेट में. So cardiac globe, you cannot see from the front, it is on the dorsal segment of the liver. It lies between the inferior vena cava and portal. Remember, so the cardiac globe is having two portions. It is between the inferior vena cava and left portal vein. And the posterior aspect, anteriorly you cannot see the cardiac globe. And you see this cardiac lobe is between the inferior vena cava and the portal vein. Middle branch or portal vein. So this is the cardiac lobe. It is having dual blood supply again from the left lobe and from the right lobe. So that is minor point, but anyway you have to keep in your mind. So the caesura. Left caesura contains the left hepatic vein, main caesura contains the middle hepatic vein, right caesura contains the right. So these are the veins, and from there will be the same line, there will be portal veins and hepatic ducts. So all these three, somewhere here, there will be three points: hepatic vein, portal vein, hepatic artery, and bile duct. And all these things, they form sinusoids in the liver, and from there, through the central vein, the blood is drained via the three veins into the inferior vena. So that is the root of this. You just go through the anatomy and physiology once again in the liver, very important. Okay, na? So the next one is the physiology and functions of the liver. Because the others are waiting, and I will send these two videos, these two PPTs, this anatomy and physiology PPTs. And physiology PPT also you go through. I will put one, because you know the physiology means how formation of the, mainly formation of the bile salts and bile pigments, bile formation, that is mainly concerned towards because of the obstructive jaundice and hepatitis and all those things. And the other liver functions, ALT, AST, and INR, PT, INR, and all those things. So I will send that PPT also today itself. You go through it, and tomorrow, day after tomorrow is also me. And this week, four classes will be of mine. So we will try to finish off those entire liver in these 4 days. Okay? I will send this anatomy and liver function tests. Investigations and liver function test PPT also. So in the next class, I will ask one or two questions on the liver function test, and I will start the liver abscess. Okay.
Yes. Sir.
Okay, Pawan.
Yes, sir.
Ni pere enta mai cheppam mai. Mai ni pere cheppu. Cheppam mai. Very good. Thank you. Radhesh. Radhesh.
నేను తీసుకుంటాను సార్ ఆర్ఎస్ దగ్గర నుంచి పిపిటి
తీసుకుంటారా
నేను అడుగుతాను సార్ ఇస్తాడులేండి పర్లేదు
ఓకే అంటే నేను ఇవ్వాలి కదా ఇక్కడ నేను ఇక్కడ డెస్క్టాప్ మీద పెట్టేసి వెళ్తాను తీసుకోండి ఓకే రైట్
ఓకే సార్ ఓకే సార్
రైట్ థ్యాంక్ యూ Yeah, I'm going to go.